The B-1B Lancer has long served as America's only supersonic heavy payload bomber. But for a time, Boeing considered extending its life as a high-speed gunship that would combine the firepower of the spooky AC-130 with the speed and maneuverability of an oversized fighter. And that just begs the question, could we really build a B-1B gunship? The Rockwell B-1B Lancer is a sweep-wing bomber straight out of the Cold War, complete with massively powerful engines that give it immense speed and a payload capacity that actually exceeds that of the gargantuan B-52 Stratofortress. The first B-1 took to the skies in 1974, but the platform itself didn't actually enter service for more than a decade, thanks to the complex and rapidly developing technological environment that was the Cold War. Slated to be replaced by platforms like the AGM-86 cruise missile and the B-2 stealth bomber before it even entered service, the B-1B Lancer has defied the odds for over four decades now. Today, the B-1B is once again expected to be sent out to pasture in favor of the next stealth bomber, the forthcoming B-21 Raider. But in 2018, Boeing began toying with the idea of stretching out the Lancer's shelf life by adding close air support to its mission profile. How do you take a supersonic bomber and turn it into a close air support Titan? Well, according to the patents filed by Boeing, it might be as simple as just adding some really big guns. Boeing's patents actually depict a number of different cannon mounting solutions for the B-1B, including a system that places a retractable cannon in the Lancer's large weapons bay. What makes these patents of particular interest is that they seem to require very little in the way of permanent modifications to the aircraft itself. That means the conversion could be less expensive than broader overhauls, and the lower the cost of such an effort, the more feasible it becomes, especially in terms of the B-1B, which is already renowned for its high cost of operation. Based on the illustrations, it looks as though Boeing doesn't have its heart set on any specific cannon, and their diagrams even show two different sizes of them mounted in the same apparatus. Visually, the cannons they use look very similar to the M230, which is a cannon chambered in 30mm, or the Bushmaster cannon, which comes chambered in anything from 25 to 40mm in size. And crazy as it may sound, there really could be something to Boeing's idea for a B-1B gunship, especially when you compare it to the new AC-130J Ghost Rider, or its predecessor, the spooky AC-130. In these C-130-based gunships, their massive 105mm cannons are longitudinally mounted in a fixed cowling on the left-hand side of the aircraft. In order to engage targets, Ghost Rider pilots have to literally bank the aircraft and circle around the target area in order to keep the cannon pointed in the right direction. Conversely, by extending the cannon apparatus down from beneath the belly of a B-1B Lancer, the weapon would be able to rotate a full 360 degrees, all while making target adjustments through a fire control module. This would allow the B-1B gunship to keep its weapon oriented on the target, even while the aircraft conducts other maneuvers. But there are also some really significant limitations that you'd have to consider when building a B-1B gunship. Because the Lancer is designed to serve as a high-speed bomber, it would really struggle to maintain the sorts of low speeds that are achievable in C-130-based gunships, even when accounting for its swing-wing design. The B-1B is also far more expensive to operate per hour than the still-in-production and rolling-off-the-assembly-line C-130-based gunships. That high-speed bomber design isn't all bad news, though, because it would really allow a B-1B gunship to reach trouble spots way faster than any C-130-based gunship could. The B-1B Lancer tops out at a blistering Mach 1.2, or right around 920 miles per hour. Compare that to the latest AC-130J, which starts to struggle after around 400. Back in 2019, I interviewed Major Michael Coyote Laney, who's a B-1B pilot instructor for the 28th Bomb Squadron. He told me that the Lancer is really tuned for down, low, and mid-level altitudes, and when you get on the throttle, it will really push you back in your seat. He went on to tell me, and I quote, "The acceleration just keeps on coming. You can go right through the sound barrier pretty quickly." As badass as the AC-130J may be, That's something it will never be able to do. And let's be honest, despite being designed to penetrate Soviet airspace by flying fast and low, the B-1B Lancer has nonetheless found itself serving in a close air support role numerous times throughout the past two decades of the global war on terror. Thanks to the addition of a Lockheed Martin-sourced Sniper Advanced Targeting Pod, the Lancer can now deliver ordnance more precisely than ever. This bomber's massive fuel stores and heavy payload capabilities also allow the B-1B to loiter over a battle space for hours, all before using its onboard fire control systems to manage targeting data relayed from ground troops or its sniper pod to deliver ordnance with pinpoint accuracy. Our B-1B pilot buddy Coyote had something to say about this too, and he told me about a time when he was deployed to Afghanistan and he received a call over the radio for troops in contact. They were on the opposite side of the country, but he was the only one in the area who could provide support, so he brought his B-1B up to Mach 1.2 and flew straight there. When he arrived, he still had enough gas left in the tank to loiter and provide support. He told me, and I quote, "So you take a platform that's on the east side of Afghanistan, and 15 or 20 minutes later, I'm showing up when there's no one else for several hundred miles who could help." All of this sounds like good news for a B-1B gunship, but don't run out and buy Boeing stock quite yet. It seems clear that American ground forces don't like to rely on precision munitions from high-flying or far-flung weapon systems when they're engaged with the enemy. The long-standing love affair between U.S. military grunts and the A-10 Thunderbolt II, commonly known as the Warthog, speaks to this very specific preference. When it comes to engaging the bad guys, ground troops prefer aircraft that actually have their eyes on the target. However, a B-1B gunship may be able to split this difference by utilizing a combination of precision-guided munitions and those onboard cannons we mentioned from the patents. And let's not forget, as it stands, B-1B Lancers are already capable of putting on quite the show when it comes to delivering air support to ground troops. Lieutenant Colonel Dominic Beaver Ross, a B-1B pilot himself and the Director of Operations for the 337th Test and Evaluation Squadron, once said, "If I'm talking to a guy on the ground and I have my sensor on him, we can drop weapons from 7 miles away, or we can drop them lower, drop them closer. We're not going to drop them as low as an A-10, but we are going to do shows of force where we're 500 feet over top of their head." So, would a B-1B gunship ever really happen? It's tough to say, but for now at least, it seems pretty unlikely. But that doesn't necessarily mean the end for this concept or even these patents. The premise of installing modular close air support cannons in an aircraft like the B-1B could very easily be modified for other aircraft. And in fact, the Air Force is already experimenting with the idea of using modular weapon systems in aircraft that were originally intended for just cargo. In other words, even though we may never see a B-1B gunship, the concept itself may yet have legs. And that about does it for this week's edition of Sandbox News. I'm Alex Hollings. Make sure you swing by sandboxnews.com today and every day for all the latest news, information, and motivation from all around the force. If you learned something today or just liked this video, please click like and subscribe down below, and don't forget to tap on that bell icon so that you never miss a drop from Sandbox News.